In this lecture, we will talk about arithmetic sequence. This is a special sequence. Later on, we will talk about geometric sequences. You see, this sequences has a pattern. Okay, is that 2, 6, 10, 14, each term 6 minus 2 is a constant. You see 6 minus 2 is 4, 10 minus 6 is 4, 14 minus 10 is 4. So he asks us to find the nth term and the fifth term. Fifth term probably is easy to find out because you know every term is that if you add 4 on the previous one, you'll get the following 10. Here we already have 4 terms right here. Then you know 14 minus plus 4 will be 18, will be the fifth term. You know, you can do this like add another 5 times, you find out 10th term. So that's not the problem. Okay. The problem is nth term. That's the general formula we want to find out. And based on that general formula, probably we can find out nth term easily. Okay. Now, this kind of sequence is called arithmetic sequence. The difference between a term and its previous term is a constant. In this case, is 4. The difference in this case is 4. And the fifth term we already figured out is 18 right here. Now, how to find out general formula? Nth term. N can be any number. If you choose 1, you get first 10. If you choose 2, you get second 10. If you choose 5, you get fifth 10, should be 18. Okay, if you n choose 10, you should have a 10th 10. Okay, 10th 10. So let's figure out that. Look, a1, a2, a3, a4, a5. This is what we already figured out. Okay, yeah, we add 4 on that, we add 4 to 14, we then get a 5th 10. Now, look. We know the difference is 4, so you know the first one add the difference will be the second one. In this case, 2 add 4 is 6, and then the following turn you add another D on that. You see 6 add 4 add a D on that, you'll get 10. Okay, so previously the first turn is the second term is the first term at D. The second, third term is the first, second term add another D, so you have 2 Ds. Okay. Now for the fourth term is actually you add 4 to the third term. Okay. But you know, we know the third term is already A1 plus 2D. And the second term is A1 plus 1D. So the fourth term will be A1 plus 3Ds. Okay, 3Ds. Yeah, you see the pattern. A1 add 4 add a D, that's the second. So we have second, A1 plus D. Add another D, you have a third one. So here is 2D, because D plus D is 2D. And then you add another D, so then you have a A1 plus 2D, then you have a 3D. So then you'll get that. Okay? And then you want to get the fifth term, you add another D to the fourth term. Okay? The 3D here, you have a 1D, so it's 4D. Okay? What's the pattern here? You have A1 everywhere here. A1. Everywhere here, and then for the fifth term here is 4, for the fourth term here is 3, for the third term here is 2, for the second term here in front of D is 1. Is 1. Okay, so here will be the pattern. If here is n, a sub n, and here should be n minus 1, this coefficient of d is always 1 less than this. 5, here is 4, 4, here is 3, 3, here is 2, and then 2 here is 1. Here is x sub 2, and then here is 1. So for the nth term, here will be n minus 1 times d. And this one is a general formula. A sub n equals what? A sub n equals a1 plus n minus 1 times d. That's the general formula. Okay? And this is true for all the arithmetical sequences. And later on, we will use that. So this is the big thing in this lecture. You want to remember that. The nth term is the first term plus n minus 1 times the difference. Times the difference. Now, what's the tenth term? Tenth term would be what? Would be a1 plus 10 minus 1 is 9 times d. And you know a1 is 2. 10 minus 1 is 9 times 4. So then you have 36 plus 2 is 38. And that will be our 10th term. So this formula is a very general formula. It applies to everywhere. Here d is 4. D might be 3 or might be even negative number. Okay? But as long as we can find out the difference, then, you know, the nth term is always the initial term, the first term, plus the n minus 1, the index, the sub-index here minus 1, times the difference. This is the general formula, and it is true for all arithmetic sequences. Okay?